took some people a long time to forgive this guy, actor Tony Goldwyn, after his first big role.
Yeah, it took me a long time. He played Carl in the movie Ghost, the treacherous schemer whose betrayal led to the death of Patrick Swayze's character, Sam.
And more recently, he was the flawed President Fitzgerald Grant on the hit show Scandal.
Now, Tony Goldwyn taking the stage in the Play Network. Of course, it is based on the 1976 film of the same name, which brought us this iconic moment.
I want all of you to get up out of your chairs. I want you to get up right now and go to the window, open it, and stick your head out and yell, I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not gonna take this anymore!
Tony Goldwyn, welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
You talk about a play for the times. This is one.
It sure is. Yeah, you know, in 1976, when the movie came out, Network, which was a satire of you know, what was happening in our media culture, and it literally has become true.
Yeah.
If you look at what's happened, you know, sort of the news as entertainment and the polarization of you know, media and news in our country with, you know, Fox News and all the different, so now it's kind of come true, and it's one of the great American films and American screenplays by this sort of genius Paddy Chayefsky. And the production we're doing, starring Bryan Cranston, who's just brilliant, is, you know, directed by this extraordinary European director, Ivo van Hove, who did A View from the Bridge a couple of years on Broadway and The Crucible, and now he's taking his spin on Network, which is amazing.
Is it weird, you know, to be in a play that's based on a movie in 1976 that's set now in 1976, but was almost foreshadowing the way news and media is now, to be in 2018, going back in time, but it's so
Yeah, it's fascinating. True. It's as if it was written for today. It could not be more timely. And what Ivo, our, you know, brilliant director, has done with this production, you feel that you're in 1976, but you also feel very much you're today. And when you see it, you know, what he's done with video and multimedia within our production, it's you're sort of sucked into this world. And it's
exactly.
It's incredibly entertaining and shocking, and it's really I feel really lucky to be a part of it.
So Bryan Cranston actually asked you to be part of this. Y'all have a long history, a bromance, if you will, together, friends
yeah,
for a long time.
Yeah, we landed on the moon together 20 years ago, and From Earth to the Moon, this wonderful HBO miniseries. I played Neil Armstrong, and he played Buzz Aldrin. And yeah, so
that's
so
awesome.
To be reconnected, what's it like?
It's just great. Bryan is just, as you may know, just the greatest guy, and I had, you know, fell in love with this Network 2 years ago. I was in L.A. doing Scandal, and I got asked to do a reading at the L.A. County Museum of Art of the screenplay of Network, just coincidentally.
Yeah.
And Aaron Sorkin, the great playwright, who was in the play on Broadway right now, To Kill a Mockingbird, Aaron read Brian's part, and I read the part I'm doing. And I thought, this is made for the stage. Why has this never been done in the theater? And I found out it was being done at the National Theater in Britain by Ivo van Hove with Bryan. And I thought, oh, God,
wow,
if this ever comes to New York, let me know. And then a couple of months ago, I got an email from Bryan going, hey, you want to come do this show with us?
Yeah.
So,
I'm in.
I'm in.
Speaking of Scandal, since you brought it up, of course, earlier this year, wraps up after 7 seasons. We had Kerry Washington on last week, and she's got a fantastic play on Bryan.
American Son. People have to go see this. She is brilliant. The play is just not to be missed. It's really
It will take your breath away.
So is that what you do? You star in a hit show and then go to Broadway?
I guess Kerry and I, you know, right before Scandal, a couple of months, Kerry and I were on Broadway together in different plays. The last time each of us were in the theater.
Really?
She was in Race and I was in a musical, Promises, Promises. And right after that, we both did the pilot for Scandal. And
wow.
Now, seven or eight years later, here we are again.
So talk about your Scandal family. Do y'all stay in touch? Are there text chains?
We stay in touch daily.
Daily?
It's a little dysfunctional. We're all having terrible separation anxiety.
Daily.
We see each other all the time. I've seen almost everybody, you know, and then we, on text chain, we talk pretty much every day. It's hilarious.
Wow.
Yeah.
I don't talk with my mom every single day, so that's impressive.
Much to your mother's chagrin.
I know. Although lately I've been better at it. I want to read your Twitter bio. Actor, director, producer, former POTUS, serial killer, and other
former
upstanding
POTUS
citizens. Why are you so good at being bad?
I try and act out in my fantasy life what I can't do in my real life.
Is it fun?
It is fun. I find villains and morally, you know,
questionable
people really interesting to play, because I think in some way we all have our, our dark side.
Yeah,
you know?
We do.
I think it all happened because Ghost was my first big break, and I played a villain in that. So when something works,
we haven't forgotten.
Commercially, you tend to people go, oh yeah. So I was offered a lot of parts like that, but they're also really, really fun parts.
What's next for you? What are you doing next?
The next thing after this, I just finished filming a new series for Netflix called Chambers, which I think comes out in the spring.
Will it be addicting?
With Uma Thurman and myself and a wonderful cast. And yeah, it's really good.
Oh,
so
good.
More to come on that.
Tell us more about it.
Who's your favorite character you've ever played?
Wow.
Well, that's a big one.
It's a big one.
Is it like asking your favorite child?
Wild, yeah. You know, Fitz was pretty great. I have to say, being able to play a character like Fitz, who just kept changing for 7 years with such an amazing cast, and speaking Shonda Rhimes' amazing words, that was pretty great.
Tony Goldwyn.
We miss him.
Thanks for stopping by. Come back and tell us more about the Netflix series when it happens.
Will do.
Previews of Network, by the way, begin this Saturday, November 10th.